Horizontal pod autoscaler automatically scales the number of pods in deployments or stateful sets based on CPU, memory, and you can even use custom metrics specific for your application. In this example, controller will scale up the replica count based on CPU utilization. In this video, we will create a Node.js Express app and simulate high CPU and memory utilization that will trigger the controller to scale up and down the application. First, let's take a look on Express app. The first endpoint is CPU, which calculates the Fibonacci sequence, which is a compute-intensive task. The second endpoint is memory. It simply creates a large array that consumes most of the available memory provided for the app. Also, we have package and package log, JSON files, and Docker file for our Docker image. For this demo, we need a vanilla Kubernetes cluster. If you want to follow along, you can create EKS cluster using eksctl. Usually it takes around 15-20 minutes to create a VPC and a Kubernetes. First of all, we need to deploy a metrics server that will be the source of the metrics for the horizontal pod autoscaler. We're gonna set metric resolution to 15, which means that it will scrape the endpoints every 15 seconds. Now let's go ahead and deploy it using kubectl apply command. After the deployment, verify that you don't have any errors in the logs. Now let's create a Kubernetes deployment with our Express app. This is a public image and you can use it in your deployment as well. Also, we need to define a resources block with requests and limits. That CPU and memory limit will be used by HPA controller to scale up or down our app. Let's create that deployment object and verify that the pod is in running state. Finally, let's create a horizontal pod autoscaler object that will define the behavior of the controller. Here we have scale up policy. It allows at most one replica to be scaled up in 1 minute. And the second is the scale down policy. It allows at most 10% of the current replicas to be scaled down in 1 minute. Optionally, you can use the stabilization window to restrict the flapping of replicas when the metrics used for the scaling keep fluctuating. Under the metric section, we define the criteria. With this metric, the HPA controller will keep the average CPU utilization of the pods in the scaling target at 80%, and the second policy will target average memory utilization. Now let's apply this object. Let's open three tabs. In the first one, we're gonna run kubectl get pods. In the second one, kubectl get HPA. And we will use the third one to run curl commands. Well, to use curl, first of all, we need to port forward port 8080 to localhost. Now we can use curl and hit our CPU endpoint. It will take around 30 seconds to increase CPU utilization, after which autoscaler will add an additional replica to our deployment. And it will take another 5 minutes to scale the deployment down. Next is a memory test. Let's use memory endpoint to create a large array. High memory utilization will trigger the controller to add a replica as well. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.